Hello and welcome to part 8 of the series on how to create your web WhatsApp UI with React.js. In this part, we are going to continue working on the chat section, which you see on the right. As you can see, we already have some messages. We don't have a timestamp on the message yet. And as you can see right here, you see a time indicator, which is today. We also don't have that. But to add this, we are actually going to create a new JSON object, or a JSON file actually. And we're actually not going to create a new one, but in our data. We have our contacts, and right here we want to add a message object to our contact object. So as you can see, this is the first contact, the name of Alex says, hey there, I am using WhatsApp. We want to add a new attribute to this one, which is messages, and then we get an array message objects, and each message object should have a message. Could be, for example, hello there. And then we also want a timestamp. We say timestamp. And the timestamp could be, for example, 2021, second month, so 02, and third day, which is 03. Then we want to specify 11 as the hour, 14 as the minute, and for example, say 00 for the seconds. So now we have a timestamp and a message. And now we also want to know from which this message was from. So was this message from Alex or was this message from us? So then we want to add a variable to here, which is from. And then we can say us or them. Right now this message is from us. Let's add a new message, which is a little bit later. So let's say 1 minute later. And then let's say that it is from them. Then let's add a couple more messages from them. Let's say hello there. How are you doing? Question mark. And then this will be in the same time category, but maybe a couple seconds later. And then we say good and you? Question mark. And then this one will be like, for example, 5 minutes later because we check our phone later. So this is from us. These are from them. And then here we have a message from us. So now we have a nice little chat history in our contacts.json. So now we actually want to update our contact model, because as you can see, we have added a new attribute, messages, to the contacts. So in the models, we want to also add this new attribute to be messages. And this is actually of type message. But as you can see, when we write in message, we don't get any model. So what we are going to do, we're going to comment this out. We're going to create a new model, which will be the message. And right here we say export interface message. And let's see what we do have in the message. We have a message, timestamp, and from. Let's see. We have message, string, timestamp, which is also a string, and then a from, which is a string, oh, as well, like so. So maybe we want the timestamp to be of type timestamp. I don't know if that's even possible, or time. But for now we're going to, maybe daytime. Yeah. But for now we're going to leave it at string. And maybe for the from, we want to make an enumerator. So we can more easily switch between two values. So for now we're going to leave it like this. So right now, in our contact right here, we have our variable messages. And we can easily say message. And as you can see, it imported it from the message model. They won't say that it's an array. So we do that by adding those square brackets. If we save this up, close this, this. We're also going to close this. We can go into our chat component. And right here, we have our messages. And actually, we want to get the messages as a parameter inside of here. So we want to make an interface props messages, which is of type message. So as you can see, the message name is conflicting with the message model, so we rename this to as message model, and then we can really easily just say message model, like so. And right here we want the message to be passed in as a parameter, like so. And right now what we can see in here is we can say Let's remove this messages from dot map. We want to map each message, and I want to create a new message like so. And let's see, we want to say if it is theirs only when the message from is them. Let's see, theirs equals. I think we can make this, for example, say true. Yeah, we want to say if m.from equals, how did we call it? Let's open up our data. If m.from equals them, then it is their message. If it is not, then this will be false. So what this will result in, this piece right here will actually always be true or false. If it is false, it's a message from us, and then this will be false. If it is true, it's a message from them, and this will be true. Let's test it out. And I think before we test it out, we still need to pass in the messages as a parameter, because right now I think we get an error in our chat box. So we actually get three errors. First is that this one expects a parameter of messages, and those two say that the messages are maybe empty. And as we can see in our validator right here, and let's open up the validator for the list, we say that it has to be of contact model. So let's see what the contact model is. Contact model says that it needs an array of messages, and as you can see, only the first contact has an array of messages and the rest don't. So if we make this nullable, for example, like so, I think the error should be gone. Yeah, but we actually don't want to make it nullable. I think what we want to do is we want to give the rest of the contacts an empty array for the messages. Let's say messages equals list of nothing, like so. So I'm going to add this to the rest. Copy this over to here, here, there, there, there. So then the error will be gone, because every contact now has an array of messages, but it's just empty. So let's see, in our chat box, we still get the error right here, but those two are gone. That's nice. So now this chat needs an array of messages, so we pass in the messages, and we say that we want to render the messages of the selected contact. So we say selected contact dot messages, like so. And if we save this up, we should see our messages being rendered. Well, we don't see them yet, and we forgot to add one thing, and that is that we want to render their content, I think. So they should be rendered right here. Let's see if we do get to see any elements. We have our chat section. No, it's just empty. Okay, let's see, the contact that we selected is Alex, which says, hey there, I'm using WhatsApp. And right here, we do have an array of messages. So I made a little mistake, and that is that I don't return anything in a map function. So as we can see right here in our chat.tsx, we map the messages, but we actually want to write return right here. Otherwise it won't return anything for each message. So if we save this up, we will see our messages. Nice. So we also see a warning in the console, and it's that each child in the list should have a unique key prop. And that is because our messages don't have a unique key prop. We're going to leave that like this for now. What you actually want is that you save the messages on a server, attach an ID to them. That ID will be unique, and that ID is what you can use right here in the browser. Or you can just create a for loop for each message, and then you can assign the value from the for loop to the message as the key. But for now, we're going to keep this. So let's see, we have our messages. But as you can see, every message is just the same. And we actually want to render the text which is inside of the message. So let's see, I'm going to close those tabs. And we are going to open up the message object, which is right here. And we already have a boolean if it is theirs. We actually also want a string for the actual message. So here we say message. It expects a message right now. And then we just want to render this message. We're going to remove this, put this inside of here, like so, save this up, and then let's see in our chat right here, we now can pass in a message. Then we say that the message is equal to the m, the message object, dot message, like so. So as you can see, we see, hello there, how are you doing? Good, and you? So that's really nice. We already got a basic conversation down. So let's see. The first thing that we are going to do is we are actually going to add some spacing between the messages. And after we've done that, we're actually going to add the timestamp to the message. Well, we're going to try to do that. So let's see, we want to add some spacing. I think it's something like 10 pixels or 5 pixels. So we are going to add that to the messages. So I think right here, where we render our message, this one, we also want a margin, I think, vertical of 5 pixels and horizontally 0 pixels. Let's save this up. And as you can see, we now have a nice little spacing on our messages. I think it looks pretty good. So now that we have that done, we can continue working on the timestamps. So as you can see right here, timestamp is being displayed on the bottom right. So to put it right there, we actually want to alter the message object. So right here, we have our message. And inside of here, we display the message. And actually, inside of this message, we also want to display the timestamp. So what we are going to do for now is we're going to make this a span. So we're actually going to do the same for this message. And what you are noticing right now is that we are actually writing the code twice. And we're going to name this content, this one as well. And writing the code twice is never good. Well, sometimes it is, but in most cases it is not. Let's see, still working. So what we actually want to do is we want to spot the differences between this piece of code and this piece of code. So let's see. We start with the first line. We see we have a div, yeah, plus a message container, message theirs, message container, message us. Okay, so the first line is differing. This is a message from us. This is a message from them. Second line is actually the same. It's a div with the class name message, like here. And the third line is actually also the same. It's just displaying the message. So the only line that's different is this one. And then we are going to look, okay, what is different? As we can see, the class name is different. So how do we fix this? More easily than repeating everything over again, we can just assign the class name dynamically. So we can, for example, write a function right here. We can say function get class name. And then inside of here, we want to check if the message is from them. So this function should get a parameter, theirs, which is a Boolean. Actually the same one right here. So if it is theirs, then we want to return something else, we want to return something else. If it is theirs, we want to return a class name, which is message theirs. Else we want to return a class name, which is message us, like so. So now that we have a function right here to get the class name, we actually want to execute that function in this place, or in this place. So we are going to do that by making this code, by adding curly brackets. Then we are going to change this to backticked, like so, or back quotes. Then we are going to create a function right here, or some piece of code inside of a string. That will be getClassName. We get class name, like so, and then we will pass in the parameter theirs. So we can then remove this, and then we can just actually copy this over to there. And I'm actually going to copy over the curly brackets as well. Let's put that right here, save it up, and as you can see, we get one error. See, the error is undefined, not assignable type of Boolean. So as we can see, theirs is a Boolean and it is actually nullable. So this value might be undefined. But right here, say that it is always a Boolean. And because right here we check if theirs is existing, we don't get an error right here because theirs is always existing. But right here, we We don't know if this will be undefined. So, we might be passing an undefined value. And a boolean cannot be of undefined, so we need to add a second type, which is undefined. And as you can see, now the error is gone. So, we save this up and refresh the page. We'll see that we still have our messages, just rendering normally. And what you might have noticed is that the difference we had between those two pieces of code are now gone. The first line was the line which was different, and as you can see, we have made it exactly the same by adding a function right here. So, what can we do right now? We can actually just copy over this, remove this whole statement, and just say return this. And if we save this up, we get the same result. And now we have way less code, and it's a lot more clear because we don't repeat the same code. So there is one last trick that I want to show you, and that is to create a shorthand function for this, or a shorthand syntax for this. So this is an if else statement. We are actually going to create a ternary operator for this. So I've talked about this in the other videos as well. So how this works is we return a value, and we actually want to write this if statement, but a lot shorter. So how can we do that? The way we do that is we write theirs, like so. So this is actually the if. Then we write the question mark, which is actually the equivalent of those two curly brackets. And now we write the value in between. We write message theirs. So if theirs, If theirs is true, then we want to return this. And now comes the else part. There's a colon, else, we want to return message us, like so. This works because, as we can see right here, we have an if statement, if theirs, then we want to return this. That is this part, if theirs, question mark. Then we return this, else, we want to return message us, else, which is a colon right here, we want to return this. So if we remove this and save it up, we see that we right now still have the same result. We have just written it in one line, and we are, well, reducing the amount of code. So I prefer it this way. It might be a little bit complicated, but let's keep it at this. So now that we have created our message object, and we actually added the message as a string, we actually want to continue on with the timestamp. So let's see. In our message, we want to create a new span, which was actually what we were doing a while ago, which will be of class name timestamp. Like so, and then let's write the message dot, and let's see, we don't have the timestamp because the message is a string. Okay, so right now the message that's being passed in is a string, so we actually want the message to be of message object. So let's see, or we actually can say that we want another attribute right here, which is the timestamp, and then that will be of type string. But, as you can see, now we have actually three attributes, which are actually part of one object. So we are actually going to remove this, I think. Let's see in our chat right here. We have the theirs. No, we are going to keep it like so. And we actually want a timestamp to be passed in. So right here, we say, we expect a timestamp, like so. Right here we say timestamp like so, and as we can see we get an error right here because now it needs a timestamp and it is equal to m.timestamp. And if we save this up, we see that we get an error still. Let's see what the error is. Ah, we forgot to add a comma. Let's save it up and refresh the page. And as we can see, we now get a small timestamp appearing right here. So what we want to do is we want to style it so it becomes a little bit smaller, a little bit gray, and then on the bottom right. So in our message.css, we have our message container, the message itself, and then right here we have the timestamp. So I want to give it a font size of 0.8 rem, something like that. Yeah, and then a color of, let's see, the same color as, for example, this one, the status of the contact. So let's look at the contact. Right here we should have the status, yes. this color, and then let's take it and put it right here. Save it up, and now we have a nice little gray text, and then we want to put it a little bit lower. So I think that we want to say position root. See what that does. Okay, so that's probably not the solution. So how about a translate? So we say transform, translate, then we want to translate it, for example, 5 pixels to the right and 10 pixels to the bottom. I don't know if the translate is actually taking in effect. No. It looks like the translate is not working. That's because the object is not absolutely positioned, I think. So actually the transform is not being applied to the span, because a span is an inline element and a transform cannot be applied on an inline element. So to fix this, we can actually display it as something other, which will be an inline block element. And because it now is a block element, but still inline, we can perform the translate. So as you can see, it's way down there. And well, you might ask, why not make it a block element? Well, then this happens. It's being displayed underneath each other. So we want to say inline block. So, and then we just want to reduce the height or the Y value for the translate. Let's go with 10 pixels, 5 pixels. Yeah, I think 5 pixels looks good. And then we actually want to render this timestamp in another format, as we see right here. Okay, so the way we are going to do this, we are actually going to strip date from there. As you can see, we only have the hours and the minutes. And then we actually want to reset the clock when it hits 12 o'clock, because then we go into PM. So let's try that out. As we can see right here, we only render our timestamp. We actually want to create a function which transforms the timestamp. So we say function get timestamp, and this function expects timestamp like so. And then here we want to call this function, and then let's see, this will be of type string. And then right here we want to return the timestamp as this. And let's create a new time object. So const date equals new date, which is starting on this timestamp. Let's console.log the date. Let's see what we get then. So if we save this up, open up our console. So we see that we get the date appearing right here. So if we refresh the page, we see it. So we get the date for every message. And what we actually want to do is we want to parse the hours and the minutes. So we say const hours equals date.getHours. I think it's a function. And then const minutes equals date.getMinutes. So let's console the hours and the minutes. So we get 11:14, 11:15, 11:20. 14, 15, 15, 20. So that's correct actually. And then what we want to do is we want to try the AM and PM out. Let's just really quickly add a new message to here. So we add a new message on the bottom. Maybe Alex was going to work, so he could only reply in the evening or in the night. So we say, I am also good. And then right here we want to say that it is sent at 8 p.m. So this should be 8 p.m. and then 20 minutes into 8 p.m. so almost 8:30. So we save this up. See a new message appearing. I'm also good. Nice. And as you can see, now we have 2020, and this should actually be 8:20 p.m. So how do we do that? We actually want to, let's see, first return something else. We want to return a string which is consisting of the hours colon minutes. So we say hours colon minutes like so. As you can see, we now have a much better timestamp, and now we want to create an AM or PM based on the hours. So for now, let's say if the hours is bigger than 12, and then we actually want to parse a string, because the hours, oh, the hours is a number, so that's good. The hours is bigger than 12, then it is PM. So let's add a suffix right here, and the suffix will be an empty string. And then right here we say if the hours is bigger than 12, suffix equals pm, else suffix equals am. So then right here we want to append this suffix. Right here we say suffix like so. Let's retry this, and we see that we have am and pm appearing. Actually want a space in between, like so. And the next thing we want to do is we want to remove 12 hours from when it is pm, I think. So we should make this a let, because if it is a const, we cannot alter it anymore. If the hours are bigger than 12, then we want to say pm, and we want to say hours minus equal 12, like so. And if we save this up, nice. We can see that we get 8:20 pm, 11:20 am. So we actually got it working. Let's see. Yeah. Well, we actually got it working. We now get the time correct, and the time is displayed on the bottom right. We get the messages. The messages are being displayed from top to bottom. So with this, I want to end this episode right here. I want to thank you for watching. I hope you could follow along. Leave a like, comment down below, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next episode. Bye.